Thank you, Yuan and Hiroki. Now, I don't think Laurent mentioned it, but we're going to continue by talking about Brexit. This time we're talking about what it's like to develop a European fintech at a time of Brexit. So before we kick off, as we've done with all our panels so far today, if you guys just want to take, we're just going to have 1 minute since this is quite a short panel, only 20 minutes long. So just 1 minute each to tell us about yourselves and your startup. So Hiroki, if you want to start.
Yeah, sure. So hi, everyone. I'm Hiroki. I'm the founder and CEO of GoCardless. And what we do is we make it really easy for businesses to accept recurring payments by building technology on top of bank-to-bank systems like direct debit.
Wow, that was quick. Johan.
Hello. I am Johan Burkovic from Bankin, CEO and co-founder. What we do at Bankin is we simplify money management. So we provide a universal app with the best user experience to manage your money, to do your daily tasks like checking your accounts, do a transfer, but also to get personal advice based on your financial data. And also you can subscribe to financial products, savings, mortgage, etc., directly in our app. So we have more than 2.4 million users across Europe today, and we are the first PSD2 license in Europe and the only one in France.
And just in case people weren't aware from your accent, you're based in France.
Yeah, I'm based in Paris, yeah.
Right, okay. Now, when the Brexit vote came through, I was at an alpaca farm in the Negev Desert. Where were you guys, and what was your reaction? Johan.
Astonished. We were very surprised. We regret the situation. While in parallel, the European Commission is trying to harmonize the market, there is a huge effort to do it, and PSD2 is one part of it. We were working during 7 years for PSD2, and this year is now the time of PSD2. And now we discover that maybe UK will be out of this subject. But there is a lot of other subjects about financial products, because it's very local market with specificities, local regulations for savings, credit, etc. For KYC, the European Commission is trying to harmonize the KYC, harmonize a regulation to distribute products across Europe, to allow a French guy to buy a German product and a German guy to buy a UK product. But now with the Brexit, we do not know how to deal with the UK.
And just to be clear, you are in the UK.
We operate in the UK, yeah.
And Hiroki?
I think for me, my reaction was a lot more personal. I live in London. We're based in the UK, and I remember waking up in the morning and seeing the news and just being in shock, really, like disbelief, because I was so certain that it would go the other way. All I really remember is turning up in the office and it feeling like a funeral, right? You know, everyone was really, really shocked that this had happened. And especially if you live in London, the sentiment in London is very different from the sentiment in other parts of the UK. So, you know, it was probably just 24 hours of pure shock. How I remember it.
Yeah, I don't think my jaw just dropped, and I was just watching the TV for just half an hour.
Couldn't
actually close my mouth for a while. While we're on the subject, Hiroki, of course. I just read, I think it was just last week, the news came out, or certainly I came across it, that you are opening an office in Paris now. Maybe Valérie Pécresse got to you earlier, on an earlier occasion. But I'm curious to know, was that anyway part of your strategy, or would that have happened had Brexit not have happened?
Yeah, I mean, the answer is yes, it would have happened. For us, the reason we're opening an office in Paris is not because of Brexit, it's because we want to be closer to our customers. And that would have happened whether Brexit had happened or not. I think that actually, in many ways, Brexit in and of itself doesn't affect us that much, because you're either a fintech company that's going to focus on an individual market, and you see a lot of fintech companies do that, or generally speaking, the fintech companies that go internationally, it's not just about one or two countries, it's about really creating a global network. And if that's the case, then you need to be able to figure out how regulation works, not in one or two countries or one or two regions, it's in many countries. So really for us, it just adds one more regulation.